Hello all, Shoestring here. Today we're going to do the unboxing and initial operation of a new charge controller I've received. This one is a Voyager from Renogy. This is a 12 volt and it can be 24 volt, 20 amp charge controller. This is a level up from what I normally purchase. This one is right around $40. If you get it retailed. Of course, there's always coupons and sales you can look at. I purchased this one because I wanted to go with one of my lithium batteries. I wanted something that specifically said it did lithium. And this one had some pretty good ratings on it. So I wanted to take a look and see. So let's go ahead and open it up. Have our normal paperwork. Thank you for being a customer. Contact us. Oh, stickers. How nice. And a user manual. User manual will come in pretty important, we think. Now, I notice this isn't just for the 20 amp. This is for the 10 and 20 amp. Keep that in mind. All right, see what else we have in here. Let me take it out. Okay, there it is. Get it out of the plastic. All right. Wonder if that's important. We'll find out. Okay, so here it is. You can see we have, it says it's a Voyager. Solar charge controller says it's waterproof. See about that. It says 20 amps there. Obviously, we have some buttons here that we're going to have to figure out how to use. That says battery type, and that says amp and voltage. Of course, we won't know anything until we actually connect it to the battery. Take a look in the back where it says solar and then battery. Wonder how they go in. It's not really set up like a regular one. Has something here for a temperature sensor, but we don't have in the box anywhere that I saw. Let's take a look at that box again. Okay. Yeah, there are some screws I didn't see, but obviously no temperature sensor. Okay, so that's what we have. And this also has battery and solar panel. So we'll take a look at this. Take out the instructions. Take a look. Maybe something like that. And we'll see what... Oh. Yeah, maybe it goes like that. After you have it connected, because you have to be able to unhook this, do the screws, loosen the screws up. Unlike some of the other ones, this also does not have, it also does not have a load. Solar, battery, but no load. Which is fine, I don't really use a load anyway. All right, so we're going to pull the manual out. We're going to take a look, see exactly how we want to get the wires in there. We'll take a look, see what we can do. And we'll be back in just a moment. All right. We're going to work on connecting the battery first. And as I said earlier, it is set up a little bit different than what you would normally expect. What I'm guessing is that it goes through these holes first and then into where it gets connected and screwed down. So, we're going to do that. Battery, which does correlate with these screws for the battery. So we're going to put the positive to slide it through here. I want to slide the negative through that one. Okay, and there they are. And remember, always do the battery first, and then the solar panels. So we're going to tighten that down, I should say, and get, let's open this up a little bit more, a little looser. Slide it in there, and then tighten it down. at the moment, folks, we're just trial and error, right? So see how it works. Bring this up and see if it fits on there. On there. All right. Seems to be in. Wonder if it'll fall off if I turn it over. Fortunately, the wires are going to help. All right, positive and negative. Our next step, of course, will be to connect it to the battery. But this is how I've decided to go ahead and hook that up on this Voyager, and we'll see how that works. Next step, hooking it up with these alligator clips to the battery. All right, we're about to connect this to the battery. The instructions say you connect it to the battery, and then it will run through a menu. Here is our new charge controller. I'm about to connect it to the battery. Oh, and here we go. This is a lithium battery. It is 200 amp hours, and it is now connected. It has come on, says 12 volt, good. And it is supposed to be running through a menu. We'll see what happens. Volts at 0.0. Okay, there's an A that went up for amps. Wait a moment. Okay. Watts. Should be volts again. Okay. And then the temperature. But I'm not so sure about that since, well, it says temperature. But we did not get the temperature sensor. When I looked through the manual, it said that comes extra. Gives you a place, but it doesn't actually come with one. So if you want a temperature sensor for this charge controller, you will have to purchase it separately. All right, so now we're going to take a look here and see what we have to do next to program this to do our lithium battery. All right, screen showing the battery voltage. Hold down battery type for 3 to 5 seconds. Battery type, 3 to 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it's now blinking. All right. Hold down battery type. We did that. It will flash. We did that. Once flashing, use amp volt button to select the proper battery type. That's right here. Oh, I didn't do it fast enough. It stopped. Okay, let's do that again. 1, 2, 3. Let's move up to this one that says gel, and that is lithium right there. Lithium. If you'll look at the manual right here, it says you have select, of course, gel, flooded, and then lithium. Actually, I said selected. I bet that actually means sealed. So that will be your AGM, that will be your gel, your flooded, and then your lithium. But since I specifically got this for lithium, that's how we're going to set it up. All right, so it's in there. It's plugged in, connected to the battery, and we do have it set up for lithium. All right, now that we have the battery cable connected and we saw that it worked, we're going to do the solar panel. Same thing, plus and minus. As you can, just like the battery, this cover has a panel and a plus and a minus. So same as we did before, we're going to feed them both through, just like that. Right. Put the positive in. Tighten it down. Then put the negative in. Tighten it down. Check it all. Don't need a loose connection. Move the cover back up. And then we'll go back to the battery and connect it all and see how this works. Okay, we've just connected the solar panel. And it is running through its menu. Again, so solar panel, 0.2 amps appears is coming in. And 13.4 is what's in the battery right now. And it goes through the temperature. I'm going to have to take a look later and see if I can make it stop going through these all the time, because it doesn't really need to. And that right there shows how many volts are coming into the battery. Right, so it has 13.4 right now. And it shows you the battery gauge in there. Shows it's going up and down, which is good. Means it's charging. There was some screws that came with this. That's if you want to take this and screw it down on a board somewhere, you're going to have it permanently. That's all that for. Okay, so the charge controller does appear to work. Like most of these other charge controllers and devices I get, I'll work it for about 4 weeks or so and then do an update and tell you how it's doing. If you like this type of video, please subscribe and like it. And shoestring